Raya and the Last Dragon, new animated film available on Disney Plus. The story starts off with an exposition dump describing the world, the humans and dragons, magic and the events of the past. I'll not recall all of them and get straight to the main part of the story, which starts a couple of years later and focuses around the titular character Raya. She's the former guardian of a magical gem that contained the magic of the last dragon, Sisu. The gem was broken along with the world, and in order to save it all, Raya has to find the mystical dragon Sisu, wherever she may have been for the past 500 years, and then gather the five pieces of the gem to reconstruct it and save the world. In the process, she visits the various districts of her mythical country, loosely inspired by various places in Asia, and gathers around herself a ragtag group of helpers with their own motivations and stories. So, in many ways, the film looks like it drew inspiration from Avatar, the animated series. Different lands with warriors using different fighting techniques, a chosen one that has to unite the country, and of course magic coupled with martial arts. Fortunately, it does still feel like just an inspiration and not a full ripoff, and there's a fair amount of original storytelling here. The second thing that immediately comes to mind is, what is up with the design of the dragon? And I don't mean its body, because the long serpent-like dragons are very typical in especially Chinese legends, but the face. It's furry and it has a very weird shape, which honestly makes it look like it was a crossbreed between a real dragon and My Little Pony. I was appalled by this design when it was first revealed, and I'm still not sold on it, but in the movie itself you do get used to it fairly quickly, I have to admit, and it certainly helps that Awkwafina is voicing Sisu and she manages to outshine the questionable looks with her great outgoing personality, so that aspect ends up working after all. Unfortunately, there was another thing which ended up being a bigger problem for me, and that is the dialogue, and specifically the language of the film. Characters often speak the way teenagers speak nowadays, with phrases and slang from the modern world being quite prevalent. Ass-kicking, badassery, or a character saying, note to self, don't die. This is something I really dislike in fantasy and in sci-fi movies. My belief is that this sort of language not only doesn't fit those worlds, but also dates the movies. After all, popular expressions evolve quite quickly, and so 10 years from now I can see people watching the film and cringe at some of the already phased out, outdated expressions. Whereas if you just had the language be more universal, have more pathos, and try to emulate what we normally associate with fantasy worlds, this problem wouldn't arise. And I can see why this was done, to better connect with younger audiences right now, obviously. But I still don't like it, and I think it's just lazy writing at the end of the day. However, having said that, I think that in terms of storytelling, the script is actually pretty good. The main thing that was very refreshing to me is that it has not just one, but actually three female characters who are not flawless Mary Sues. There's Raya, obviously, who is capable physically, good fighter, smart about it, but she's very distrustful of people, and often proceeds straight into conflict without exploring other options first. Then there's the antagonist Namari, who is conflicted between wanting to cooperate with others and being bound by a sense of duty towards her people and her mother. And finally, Sisu is a happy-go-lucky dragon that wears her heart on her sleeve and trusts everyone else, everyone she meets, which does serve as a vehicle to teach Raya the lessons of trust and cooperation, but it is also shown backfiring when Sisu trusts the wrong people sometimes. I really liked all those dynamics. And also, what's crucial is, for all three of those characters, we can see why they are the way they are. We can see how life shaped them. So it's not that they have this character just because, but there's a really logical explanation for their outlooks on life. So I really liked all of this, because lately it seems like a lot of the female protagonists are made to be, you know, strong and powerful and without any flaws, which really makes them not so interesting as characters. If there is no growth to be had, if they're perfect from minute one, from the start, then what's the point of the story? This problem does not apply to Raya and the Last Dragon at all. The character arcs are fantastic, and the climax of the film did something I didn't expect but thought it was fantastic and emotional storytelling, in some ways reminding me of the climax of the original Guardians of the Galaxy. And that's not to say that the story is completely flawless as well. Right before the climax, there is a final duel between Raya and Namari, which, because of what's happening around them at the time, feels like it really has no clear stakes. They're fighting, but what is the goal for either one of them? What are they trying to achieve here? There's nothing to be gained, basically. So it feels like a bit of a clunky writing. Oh, you had these characters at odds for the whole film, so they need to fight at the end. And one of the side characters is also a toddler that's capable way beyond her age and annoyed me to no end for reasons I can't quite explain. I guess I just don't like these types of cartoonish characters and wasn't amused by it. And also the whole beginning of the conflict, the whole setup in the movie seems like it could have been avoided very, very easily, but has the characters acting kind of hypocritically and very self-righteous, which ends up leading to trouble. But even with these issues, I think the movie ends up being pretty solid because of how well it ties up the main character arcs and how well it manages to handle the character of Raya being, strong and inspirational and admirable, but also conflicted and flawed and making mistakes. Because I think showing children that even great people can make mistakes and can learn from them and grow to be better is a great lesson.